What's going on, my good people? Mike Hidalgo here. Thank you for joining us on another FCP Euro Tech Tip. Today, we're going to be talking compression testing and why you may want to look into it. A compression tester is going to give you the ability to measure the overall health of your combustion chamber within your engine. A couple things that may affect that are bad valves, bad sealing rings, a blown out head gasket, but also keep in mind that the readings may be skewed due to a weak starter or a bad battery or a slow cranking engine. So those are just a couple of things to take into consideration when doing a compression test. If you're looking for a more integral, in-depth test, then you want to look into a leak down test, which uses compressed air so that your settings are always consistent. Now, before we get into the actual testing of the combustion chambers, you want to take a couple of things into consideration. First, when you're testing the engine, you want to remove all of your spark plugs so that you have a consistent reading across the board and you're not building pressure on three cylinders while you're testing number four. Secondly, you want to determine whether to do this hot or cold. If the engine has a serious issue, you don't want to run it for a long period of time, risking damaging it further, so you want to do it cold. Now, just also keep in mind that a hot engine is going to have a higher tolerance. Everything's warmed up and up to spec, so your readings may be a little bit different. You're looking for consistency across the board. You don't want to have one cylinder read 80 PSI as an example, and then the rest of them read 180 PSI. If you have that, then you know that you have a problem, and it's going to require further investigation. Before we do any actual work to the W204, we're going to go ahead and compression test it, check how much compression each cylinder is making, and hopefully get a consistent reading throughout all four cylinders. So with that being said, let's go ahead and get started on this test. Now, just a rule of thumb, when you're checking an engine, you want to get at least 135 PSI, if not more. Obviously, if you're reading 80, even below 100, then it's safe to say that something is wrong internally in your combustion chamber. Now, with that being said, once you have your readings and you've wrapped up, you'll be able to determine, A, if you need to investigate further, maybe borescope, or maybe actually take the engine apart, or B, if you're ready to purchase the vehicle, slap on the bolt-ons, or simply complete your tune-up and get back on the road. So let's check our numbers and see where we end up at. Now, before we go ahead and actually hook up our OTC tester to the engine, there's a couple things to take into consideration. Like I mentioned at the beginning, you want to remove all of your spark plugs. This car is equipped with ignition coils, so we're going to remove all four ignition coils and then pull all four spark plugs. On some vehicles, mostly newer vehicles, you're able to just get away with having someone inside the vehicle, depressing on the accelerator pedal while they turn the key to keep the engine from starting. On some older vehicles, you can disconnect the fuel injectors, you can disconnect the distributor, you can disconnect your fuse or your fuel pump relay. So in this case, we're gonna have someone inside the vehicle depressing on the accelerator pedal. You're gonna wanna crank the engine over about 6 to 8 times. That's 6 to 8 compression strokes, so you can get an accurate reading. And then from there, you'll be able to jot down all your numbers and then measure across the board. And hopefully you have consistent numbers. So we're going to pull out these ignition coils really quick. We'll pull out the spark plugs and then we'll hook up the tester. Let's do it. Now we're just going to go ahead and turn the motor over a couple times. This engine specifically, the spark plugs came out submerged in oil. So we're going to lay this over the top, crank it over a couple times just to clear the chambers, and then compression test it. Now we have our proper adapter for our compression tester. We're going to go ahead and get it situated in cylinder 1, and then we'll repeat the steps from 2, 3, and 4. Most compression tester kits are gonna come with different attachments that have different thread pitches depending on the spark plug thread that your engine uses. So just make sure you find the right one. Start them all by hand. You don't wanna cross thread your cylinder head by accident. Once you have that situated and on your tool, go ahead and feed it into the cylinder you're gonna test first. Write down your numbers once you get 6 to 8 compression strokes on the gauge, and then repeat for the rest of the cylinder. So you're gonna see us do the first one, and then we'll zoom through the other three. Good. All right, that was healthy, 180. Let me set up in cylinder 2. Good. Good. Rip it. Good. All right, my good people, if you were able to see that gauge, our numbers read pretty consistently across all four cylinders between 180 and 184 PSI. So that gives us a good indication that more than likely this engine's in okay health. Again, a leak down test would be the proper way to really, really try to narrow down what's going on so you can have consistent pressure from a compressor. At this point, we're gonna go ahead and continue diagnosing this car separately, but hopefully this compression test video helped you out. Hopefully your project checks out and you can continue to get back on the road. So if you like this, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments on what we did today, leave them in the comment box below. And if you like this tech tipping, you want to see more like them, please consider subscribing. We're working on them all the time. As always, thank you for watching. We'll catch you in the next one.